Hello students, today we are going to talk about optical fibers. Optical fibers, as you can see in the figure, there are three figures. One figure shows the cable, the colored fibers inside the cable. Then you have the real fiber, how it looks like. You can see yellow color, the fiber core, glass or plastic cladding over the core, and you have a plastic jacket over the cladding. Finally, you can see how the propagation takes place inside the fiber through total internal reflection. There are certain more clips on optical cable. You can see here in the figure. You can see the light at the tips of the fiber and a bundle of cable. Now, let us discuss why optical fibers are better than their counterparts, that is the copper cables, and why they are replaced. So we have an overview of optical fibers. Firstly, we talk about speed is the important factor. The fiber optic networks operate at high speeds as compared to the copper cables, that is up to the gigabits. Then the bandwidth carried by an optical fiber is very large as compared to a copper cable. The distance traveled by the signal to be transmitted further without needing any refreshed or strengthened signal. That means you don't require a repeating station after every 50 or 100 kilometers as you need in a copper cable. Moreover, the resistance provided by an optical fiber is also enormous because it provides resistance to electromagnetic noise such as radios, motors, or any nearby cables or any heavy industries generating electromagnetic noise. Then we have maintenance. The optical cables cost much less to maintain, and the most important parameter which we can discuss here is the security. As the modulation is intensity modulation, it is not direct modulation, as the signal is optical in nature, so direct tapping of the signal is not possible as is possible in a copper cable. Now, this is the reason an optical fiber has enormously replaced the conventional copper cable. The reasons are mentioned earlier also, because optical fibers are much smarter than their counterparts, the copper cables, and eventually are now very less costly because they throw optical signal instead of electrical signal at the speed of light. We have a brief introduction of optical fibers. An optical fiber is a long, thin, transparent dielectric material which carries EM, that is electromagnetic waves of visible and IR frequencies from one end to the other end of the fiber by means of TIR, that is total internal reflection. The glass or the plastic is used as the dielectric material here. That means that optical fibers works as waveguide. In optical television signals, the video signals, the digital signals, and the data signals are all transmitted through the optical fibers from one end to the other. Now let us have a look at the structure of an optical fiber. As you always know, there is a core, then there is a cladding, and then there is a polyurethane protective jacket. Optical fiber works on the principle of total internal reflection. Once the light ray enters into the core, it propagates by means of multiple TIRs at core cladding interface. Now let us have a look at the transmission, how it takes place. You see, you can consider a normal to the surface, two surfaces, and a normal to the surface, a rarer medium and a denser medium. Theta is the angle of incidence and R is the angle of refraction. Now what you see here, when you see that when theta is greater than theta C, the critical angle. Why we call it critical, we'll know later. When we say theta is lesser than theta C, then the incident ray is propagated in the rarer medium. But when we say that theta is equal to theta C, that is theta is equal to the critical angle, and that is 90 degree. In that case, what happens? R is 90. In that case, what happens? The ray is being transmitted through the two medium boundary. But in the third case, what happens is, when theta becomes greater than critical angle, then, that is the launching angle becomes greater than the critical angle, then the incident ray reflects back from the rarer medium to the denser medium, that is reflects back to the denser medium, and finally you have a ray launched inside a core of the fiber, which we will discuss later. That means that the ray is being trapped inside a cylindrical surface, and this ray, due to multiple reflections due to the surface, can reflections due to the surface can travel inside the core of the fiber. According to law of refraction, n1 sin theta is equal to n2 sin theta and r sin r, or theta is theta c, then r is 90 degree. This is the condition we follow. Then sin theta c is equal to n2 by n1, that is sin 90 degree, or sin theta c, that is the critical angle, is n2 by n1. That is, critical angle is a ratio of the two refractive indices. Now, what is an acceptance angle? The maximum angle of incidence at the end face of an optical fiber for which the light ray can be propagated along the core cladding interface is known as the maximum acceptance angle, and it is also called the acceptance cone half angle. You can see here how the acceptance cone takes place, that means how the ray is being propagated inside the core. You see that the red dashes line indicates the core and the blue dashed line indicates the cladding. But the ray incident at an angle theta greater than theta c, the ray is reflected back into the system in the core at the upper interface at B. And finally, at the lower interface also, if the same conditions are matched, the ray will be reflected back and the ray will be trapped inside the core and will propagate inside the core. So n0 sin theta 1 I is equal to n1 sin theta r. From the right angle triangle ABC, as you see in the figure, theta r plus theta is equal to 90 degree, or theta r is equal to 90 degree minus theta. So n0 sin theta 1 is equal to I is equal to n1 sin theta 90 degree minus theta, or n0 sin theta I is equal to n1 cos theta, or sin theta I is equal to n1 by n0 cos theta. This is equation 2. So when theta is critical angle, theta c is equal to theta m, that is theta maximum. So sin theta maximum is n1 by n0 is equal to into cos theta c. According to law of refraction, n1 sin theta I is equal to n2 sin theta r. If I is equal to theta c and r is equal to 90 degree, then sin theta c is equal to n2 by n1 sin 90 degree, or sin theta c is equal to n2 by n1 simply, or cos theta c is equal to under root 1 minus sin square theta c, or that is equal to under root 1 minus n2 upon n1 whole square, or you can say cos theta c is equal to n1 square minus n2 square upon n1. This is equation 4. That is, if the medium is surrounding the fiber is here, then n0 is equal to 1. So sin theta m, that is the maximum angle of launching, is given by under root n1 square minus n2 square. And theta maximum is equal to sin inverse under root n1 square minus n2 square, which is required expression for maximum acceptance angle in an optical fiber. What is acceptance cone? Rotating the acceptance angle about the fiber axis describes the accepting cone of the fiber. Light launched at the fiber end within this acceptance cone alone will be accepted and propagated to the other end of the fiber by total internal reflection. You can see here the figure indicating the acceptance cone. That is, if throughout the axis, if you rotate the acceptance angle, you'll get a cone. And the rays incident in this cone only will be propagated inside the core. The rest of the rays will be rejected. What is numerical aperture? The light gathering capacity of an optical fiber is known as numerical aperture, and is proportional to the acceptance angle. And it is numerically equal to the sine of the minimum acceptance angle. So the ratio between the difference in RIs of the core and cladding is that to that of the refractive index of the core is called the fractional change in the refractive index. So numerical aperture can also be defined as Na is equal to sin theta maximum, or sin theta max is equal to n1 square minus n2 square by n0, or numerical aperture is equal to n1 square minus n2 square, or Na is equal to under root n1 minus n2 into n1 minus n2, n1 plus n2 into n1 minus n2, when n is equal to n0 is equal to 1. So for air, so delta is the change in the refractive index, the fractional change, then delta is equal to n1 minus n2 upon n1, or numerical aperture can be defined as under root n1 delta n1 plus n2. When n1 is far nearly equal to n2, then the numerical aperture is equal to under root n1 square 2 delta, or numerical aperture is equal to n1 under root 2 delta. Now we discuss the types of optical fibers. On the basis of variation of the refractive index of the core, the optical fibers are mainly classified into following types. That is, the step index fiber and the graded index fiber. Why we call it step index and graded index, we will know a little while. Based on the mode of the propagations inside the fibers are further divided into single mode fibers and multi mode fibers. So you can classify as a step index, single mode, and graded index single mode, graded index multi mode, and so on. Now you can see what is a single mode step index fiber. When the refractive index is common for the core in the fiber, as we go radially from center of the core, the refractive index undergoes a step change at the core cladding interface. The core diameter of the fiber is about 8 to 10 micrometers, and outer diameter of the cladding is around 60 to 70 micrometers. There is only one path for light ray propagation, hence it is called a single mode step index fiber. It is a reflective fiber since light is transmitted from one end to the other end of a fiber by total internal reflection. These are extensively used because the distortion and transmission losses are very, very less. Then we can see the refractive index profile of a single mode step index fiber. Here you can see the outer diameter, that is the cladding, is 60 to 70 micrometers, and the inner diameter is 8 to 10 micrometers. So it becomes very difficult to launch the light inside a single mode fiber, but it is good for long haul communications, as only a single mode is traveling inside the fiber, so the losses between the modes are not there. You can see the refractive index profile. You can see here the refractive index of the core is same throughout and the cladding is the same throughout. Hence it forms a step function, that is why we name it as step index fiber. Then we say a single mode. Again, if a single pair of ray is launched inside, then we say that a single mode has been launched inside the fiber, and we say it is a single mode fiber. Now we talk about the multi-mode step index fiber. The construction of this fiber is similar to a single mode fiber, but the dimensions of the core and the cladding are much larger to have more number of paths for light propagation. The core diameter varies from 50 to 200 micrometers. You can see from 60 to 70 it has become 50 to 200 micrometers. So such a radical change is there, and the cladding diameter varies from 100 to 250 micrometers. Again you can see there is a change. So it is also a reflective fiber since light is propagated in the form of multiple total internal reflections. Now you see the refractive index profile of a single mode graded index fiber. You can see here the cladding and the core diameters, and you can see that the refractive index is center, it's maximum at the center of the core and reduces at the end of the core. And finally, this is grading of the refractive index, and the core has, the cladding has the same refractive index throughout. Now we talk about a graded index fiber. In this fiber, really the RI of the core continuously decreases from the center to the surface, as already discussed. The RI is maximum at the center of the core and minimum at the surface. This fiber can be a single mode or a multi-mode depending upon the cone of acceptance. The diameters of the core cladding varies from 50 to 200 micrometers and 100 to 250 micrometers respectively, depending upon the single mode or multi-mode fibers. You can see the refractive index profile of a single mode graded index fiber. You can see the core and cladding diameters here and see the diagram for the refractive index profile. As the refractive index changes continuously radially in the core, the light ray suffers continuous refraction within the core from its surface center to the surface. Thus, the propagation of light rays are not due to total internal reflection but by refraction. Therefore, it is called a refractive fiber. In this fiber, the light rays travel at different speeds because of RI in different parts. Near the surface, RI is least, so the light rays travel faster compared to the light rays near the axis. Because of this, all the rays almost arrive at the same time at the end of the fiber. You can see the light propagation in a multi-mode graded index fiber. You can see here these eye patterns, they form the multi modes of an optical fiber, and you can see the cone of acceptance where so many pairs of rays has been launched inside the core. Thank you.